Ey, we're here. So, first things first. I created a tier list for the games in general, so we can update that as we go as well. So, last time, as you remember, Mega Man 1 landed in C tier. And hi, Entity, welcome, glad you could make it. Wolfgang. So, yeah. Let's see where Mega Man 2 falls. Hint, lower. Okay, Bravi, let me explain. Due to E3 happening tomorrow, I wanted to push this forward to today, because I wanted this to get some traction instead of Pokemon. Because this is something I would actually enjoy more right now. Arara! How many deaths are you? Keep track in the chat! Thank you! Right, I should change the options. There you go. Change that, and now we're ready to go. Mega Man 2. Oh god, I gotta read out text. In the year of 2000X, a super robot named Mega Man was created. Dr. Light created Mega Man to stop the evil desires of Dr. Willy! No way, it's Wily, oh god. However, after his defeat, Dr. Wily created 8 of his own robots to counter Mega Man! This team was support Flash Games! Time for the big gay. Oh yeah. Absolutely. Absolutely. Something about him, guys, you can kill the blow. Oh yeah, you can. He just created 8. 8. Just 8. So since I'm playing the English version here, we have normal difficulty, which is literally just an easy mode, and difficult mode, which is literally just Japanese mode. Take a wild fucking guess what I'm going with. Helmet Lassaiwear. I cannot talk today, apparently. Like, Mech Man 2, but the intro skyscraper is infinitely tall. Yes! Yes! Okay, so who the fuck are we gonna start with? And I guess we're going for the meme first, because, as we all know, I can't defeat Airman! Woo! Okay. So, first things first, I really gotta say, I do not like this stage theme at all. Like, okay, starting off, we got these funky I don't know what they are, but what they do, they serve the purpose of making the stage take longer than it should. Because it literally just, it's a waiting simulator. Just gotta wait for the horns to retract, and there you go. Why? Oh, speaking of waiting simulator, this. I feel like this could have been a bit faster, honestly. Like, not ludicrously faster, but just a tiny bit, please, because this is a slog. And I mean, if you're gonna put me above, like, bottomless pits for so long, at least make it a bit more interesting. Oh well. Damage boost again. Honestly, though. Oh, if Pippi's in. I don't know if that would be a good idea. I don't know. Like, especially like for a first screen, not. But maybe if they. Alright. Let's go! Alright. This shares a screen. This sure is a screen. Yes. Imagine everything drops with death behind the cloud. Yeah. Yeah. So this section is literally just the first section, but if you time this wrong, good luck avoiding damage or something. This ain't Dark Souls 2, Seb. Okay. Oh yeah, these things are kinda glitchy actually, sometimes. Like, they can't blow you off the screen, which is great, because they just despawn before that. Good. And yeah, sometimes they just kind of despawn on their own, which is... Sure is. But yeah, Pippies are fucking annoying enemies, I gotta say. Yeah, either you shoot their eggs or they just... They spam their little babies and it's the worst. They are a fat Mega Man, kind of. Well, technically they are, My 3D Sonus and likes here, and nice to follow because the logo is blue away. Yeah, the faces aren't the most sightly things. So, beating Airman, not hard. No, damaging Airman? Fucking impossible. I've done it before, but... But yeah, as you can see, I'm just really playing badly against him, but if you just button mash through it, there is no way you should not be able to beat Airman. Like, you'd have to be the worst gamer ever to not beat Airman. Like, just keep shooting. I know it sounds dumb, but it's literally what it is. XX first one out, XX. Not a pet peeve of mine. So the guy who made this... Yes, exactly, that guy sucked ass. Harbinos Airman 2 confirmed. Low tiers, absolutely. This weapon get screen is so bad. It's another reason why I hate replaying this game, because this just takes so long! Like, why would you do that? Okay. Let's get the tier list on. Airman... Airman Sprite. There he is. There he is. There he is. Okay. Well, where are we placing him? What do you feel like? What am I feeling like? See, the thing is... The stage was kind of too short to do anything with its gimmicks. Like, I would have preferred like a second... oops. Would have preferred like a second section with those cloud platforms or something. But as it is, it's just boring and... Exactly, DD would be generous, actually. But the thing is, even the theme sucks, and it's just a spam of stupid birds, bottomless pits, waiting as fuck. Everyone's saying D, but I feel like I'd have to go with E, honestly. Yeah, Tutari is speaking my language. You know, we're doing one star, but the first stage is an E. Right. Who are we doing next? Not Death Plus. Okay, you know what? Let's knock out another huge stinker next. Heatman. Good start, good start. So Heatman is based on a lighter. Like a zipper lighter. Think about the Wily stages. Oh yeah. So yeah, this shares a stage. And at least it's a bit more involved. Like you actually have like lava here which you can survive if you get hit. Then they just spam these tellies randomly, it's kind of, You can bully the lighter while I'm around. I can! If I want to, I can. Yeah, this is a bit of a wonky section. Especially if you wanna jump over them. Kinda weird, isn't it? And to make the stage so much better. Why? Why add these again? Spit on his wife. I spit on his wife! Yeah! Take that, you dick! I'm spitting on your wife! And I forget how to do Yoku blocks! Yeah!
There's a giant brick tube of lava. What else is.
I feel like it's supposed to be like a sewer, but I don't get why it would be a lava sewer? Yeah, it's Iceman, but worse, kind of. Except it's not with the footholders or anything. So I have item 2, but I just wanna... give this a shot at least. In the sewers! Lava sewer kind of Mario. What, does Mario have lava sewers? Does it?
Don Corneo.
Genius, you're hired, honestly though. But as you can see, this is like... Keep in mind, you could do the stage first if you wanted. Sure is. Oh yeah, I've got a lot of fire still. The sound effect is driving me. Yeah. See, that's the actual part of the song that makes sense. This section is fucking bullshit. Of the I Can't Defeat Airmen song, I mean. You know what? Let's just fuck it, I'm not bothering with that. Point is, it's stupid. Oh jeez, that might be too low. Ooh! Ah, that was perfect placement of that, haha. You missed out the funny crash bomb on. Yeah, that's so useless. And then we get this game's version of a big eye. Which has two phases. First one is literally just a big eye, but the second one spawns a Sniper Joe. But at least the Sniper Joes aren't that bad anymore. My right click is almost dead. That's not good. Sniper Jojo, hell yeah. Bazooka Jojo. So heat, man. First wave, you gotta dodge legitimately, but after that you can just do a funny dance with him if you're fast enough. Like, at least this fight is more involved than Fireman's in Mega Man 1. But yeah, he still does a crap ton of damage with his fire dash. But I guess that makes sense. One. Alright, we are doing a counter, hell yeah. So yeah, just do that. Yeah, the thing that makes this hard is just that he's like on a random timer which decides when he dashes. Could make it instantly or could make it wait for like half a minute, which, you know. But overall, Heatman is not a hard boss once you get into the rhythm of this shit. The thing that makes this hard is that it's boring. Yeah!
Remember time we got some burst with dodging little heat.
It's not hard! It's not hard to dodge it! Like, honestly. H! Get equipped with H! Atomic Fire, which is literally just a charge shot that sucks ass. Yeah, Atomic Fire sucks so hard. Like, you get two full charge shots out of that and that's it. If you miss with that, good luck. Use it. Yeah, maybe I'll use it in some stages. But yeah. I mean, I wish I was a charger that's... tech that's called farting. With item 2 it feels it should be better than Airmen, but... Yeah, that's the thing. Item 2 should not be a requirement to beating a stage. Unless it's a Wily stage, I guess, but we'll get to that when we get to that. Heatman Sprite! Yeah, he is. There's the lad. Everyone's already saying F, okay.
You know me, I'm a very... little person, so
you know me too well, because I was absolutely putting him in an F tier. The first stage of grief. What the fuck, no S. Oh boy. Stray White Pixel, I do not care. Right, next up, I guess we can do Crash Man. Oh yeah, fun fact, if you hold down A during the black part of this boss intro, the stars turn into birds. He looks so kickable. Oh yeah. It's a good start when it's just, it feels so cramped already. Like, ugh. What is this, a Game Boy game? I feel very claustrophobic already. Heatman and Quickman, there was a border for a reason. Crashman stopped working, yeah, 4-4. I mean, the background is blue already, so it's literally a blue screen of death, isn't it? Close! It's literally cock and balls on the one. Yeah. So I could do this, these boring ass sections, but fuck that. Like, these sections, I get that they're trying to get more complex and stuff, but it just once again turns into stupid ass waiting. Like, there's just no reason for this to be there. Anyways. That's like the only use I could find for a charge shot here.
Crashman stage is supposed to be skyscraper, rocket launch station. It's such a video.
Real cheesy, always, always.
Another Porn Flash song? I didn't know all that. Why didn't know so many Porn Flash songs?
Yeah, that's a bit of a tight dodge, but I actually liked it. That's kind of nice.
Like, yeah, you fall and stuff, but it's at least a precarious situation for once.
Not this! Fucking sucks.
Wanna know why? You just climb and...
How are you supposed to dodge these? You can't! You just can't! Like, unless you have Woodman's weapon or do some really tricky shit with pause buffering on a ladder, it's not possible to dodge that. Which, you know... Fast damage, my favorite!
Yeah. There's a way to dodge it, be or whatever, but...
Exactly. Like, when you need a fucking technique for something as simple as just climbing a ladder, you know something's wrong. E-tanks, new to this game, allow you to quickly refill all of your health, energy, if you're in a pinch.
You can with stupidity and no stuff.
And now we just get a bit of enemy spam. My favorite.
I'm really idiot.
Technique! Technique, 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 technique! You gained a severed head. Now, Crashman! Crashman is very pattern based. Once you get into his pattern, he's extremely easy.
This section before, but it's very specific. Not jumping into the doors.
Sometimes I do it, sometimes I don't. I don't know. But yeah, Crashman, once again, as I said, pattern heavy, not hard, just. Just boring. Just boring. And yeah, the sprite flicker in this game is on a whole new level of bad. I did turn on turbo. The flickering is still there though, that's the issue. You can't remove the flickering from these games, even with turbo.
Just boring once you know it well, fought him once, you fought a million then.
Exactly. Like, yeah, you can do this sneaky tactic where you can hit him multiple times per pass, but it's like, meh. It's flashbang. No, that's just a fucking sprite flicker of the game because it can't handle this bullshit. Oh, but just wait until we get to the real sprite flicker adventures. That's gonna be... Why no charge of him? I think he's immune to heat, to atomic fire.
Fast damage sucks, waiting one with burst in air, and thinking...
Think fast, chuckle nuts. Now, Crash Bomb is gonna be the cataclysm to something F-rank worthy later on, but we'll get to that when we get to that. For now, I need a Crashman image. Crashman sprite. Yeah, there's my man. That's my man, Crash. Yeah, the only reason we're short is because we didn't get a utility, but even still, it still took a while. Okay. So... Something's... I should turn on tolerance, maybe. Ah, whatever. So... I should maybe not put him on the same layer as Heatman. That would be a good idea, wouldn't it? Fucking hell. I keep forgetting that I need to actually do layer stuff here. The arm post though, honestly. So, Crashman. I don't think it was as bad as Heatman, but the unavoidable damage, the giant amounts of waiting in the first half, and just how long the boss fight drags, I would say E. And I would say worse than Airman. So, yeah. Yeah, E meme here, oh yeah. Oh yeah, absolutely. So I guess now that we got all these fuckers done, I guess we can now go to Flashman. With the same lair, hell yeah. Shoutouts to my man Flashman over here. Cool lad. So, not only is this stage constantly flashing, which could be problematic on the ice, it's also a ice level. Yeah. I don't know why. I guess it's just so polished that it's just the slippery floor. Yeah, I don't know, man. Flashman O2 here. Hey. Xenoblade Ice Physics? Xenoblade Ice Physics are fun! So, the thing with this stage is, you want the utilities. Why? You get some extra goodies if you do. You didn't see the white floor sign. And yeah, these walls are Crash Bumper walls. Normally, I'd be totally against using Crash Bomber at all, but it's in a normal stage, so meh. And sometimes these walls can actually drop stuff, which... interesting, I guess. What happened to his face? Yeah, using Crash Bomber lets you skip this motherfucker, which is pretty good, I would say. And yeah, there's so many split paths here that... sure is a thing, I guess. Let's see if I can do the jump. I can do the jump earlier! I suppose the maze was actually my mineral mining facility. It's the face of evil! So we go over here, I think over here is where you can skip another enemy. Yep. And if you fall down here, you can just skip this motherfucker as well. See, the thing is, I like where it's going with the idea of, yeah, you can kind of choose your own path in a sense. Man, just don't buffer stream. Bad stream. E-tank! But if you don't have some of these utilities to go these alternate paths, you have to deal with so many of these mechs. And that's just kind of a pain. Dashman. Moonwalk! Now Flashman is, how do I put it? Annoying? Yeah. Always jumps when you hit him. He stops time, shoots somewhere, and yeah, it's... He just kind of walls you sometimes, which... He stops time! He is the out! Dude! E tier below. So, the thing is, I had an easy time with the stage right now because I literally skipped all the hard parts. So I'm not sure how to rate this. Like, there's a lot of tight corridors, a lot of chances for you to just get hit if you don't know the proper route. And yeah, that's... The slipperiness of the stage also did not help at all, so that's kind of annoying. Let's call him Mashman. Mashman is a real Chad, isn't he? Absolute unit. Alright, let's get the Flashman sprite over. Flashman sprite. It would help if I actually inputted it correctly in Google Images. Thank you. Okay, what are we doing with you, my boy? What are we doing? If you skip the enemy split paths, I will see no crash bomber, lots of spam. The thing is, it is more involved than some of the other stages so far. Because it actually rewards you for, like, doing some wacky stuff with your weapons. Might be a bit weird, but I'm putting it on D tier. Still not good, but it's more acceptable. It's more acceptable. Right. Daniel. Who's Daniel? Right, who are we tackling next? I'm feeling Woodman. Why am I feeling Woodman? I don't know! I don't like Woodman's stage theme though. That is quite the bomb. So these... Most of these bats don't really serve a purpose because you can just outrun them all. Really the only issue in this first... Yo, this is Vietnam! The only issue in this first screen is just the robots. Like even here you can... Yeah. Great. But here you actually have to fight some stuff. I mean, I guess... Like, the first one is not that hard. And the second one actually evolves the gimmick somewhat, having you be a bit closer to him and having to actually do some tricky jumping. This is what I call evolution of a gimmick, and it's not done that badly. And here, you gotta be a bit more precise still. I actually like that. I think that's not that badly done. Didn't Gaijin Guma make a video about this actually being Vietnam? No, Vietnam was Napalm Man in Mega Man 5. Exactly what Inter said, yeah. Oh, and that's also why that game is totally banned in Vietnam. Great, isn't it? Gotta love being controversial, don't you? But yeah, let's see. Oh yeah, this section. Once again, you could just rush it, but then these fuckers jump at you and it's just annoying. Yo. Sometimes these item drops are just a fucking meme, man.
Monkey man! I love it.
And yeah, pippies once again. I hate pippies, they suck. They are the scum of the earth. Wasn't there supposed to be another gorilla man that spawned here on this platform? I feel like I despawned him.
That's weird. Monkey! Monkey!
And now this section. Fucking
alright, alright.
Yeah, this section is a bit wonky as well because you gotta get really close and personal with this robot. And use the sign known as Kong. Oh yeah, I have seen that. That is interesting to say the least. And it also depends on the phrase you kill the enemies on, which is why you start to see a lot of duplicate drops and come the same. I guess that makes sense. And now there's this last section before the boss, which is just ostriches. Why ostriches? I don't know. Oh, it's a Roadrunner? Yo, it's Cox! But sure, that is a thing. And yes, things. Always. Chicks. So Woodman is a really poopy fight, actually. Not only is dodging his leaf shield really hard because the sprite is actually humongous, you also gotta dodge the leaves and their pattern is a bit dogwood. Oh, we'll get to dogwood. We'll get to dogwood, don't you worry. To back that. But yeah, we're getting to dogwood eventually. That's gonna be a treat. But yeah. Woodman, meh. Like, we can't speed kill him and I'll show that later, but meh. Tonight on Bottom Gear, oh yeah. My warning mood. DK, why we're laughing in front. So yeah, actually getting to the other side of Woodman, because he always jumps towards you. It's not easy. Not easy at all.
Could you be in the bottom left and jump?
You could?
Yo, it's Mega Man's don't be!
But yeah, Woodman, pretty poopy boss. What a waste of good wood. Yeah, what a waste. Really, the thing that brings the stage down is just a fight, and I guess I can kinda look past that. Cause it would be weird if every fight was easy, you know? Definitely feels like the best stage so far. Let's see where we can place it. Woodman Sprite! Also, shoutouts to the Silver Gunner memes of nice. Always a treat. Gotta love those Woodman remixes. Come on. Come on. There we go. Right,
the movement calls you and need to slowly shear because the tide even tighter for dogwood.
Exactly. Yeah, there we go. So, as I said though, the hot dog section, for example, was pretty well developed actually. And other than that, I mean, it was nice and rompy. But I feel like I could have done a bit more. With like the treetop section maybe, or maybe the ostriches. Like, I would have to say C tier because so far it excels in a sense. Still not outrageously good, but it's acceptable. Fullwood before Birchwood. It's not a B tier, definitely not. Yeah, like the thing is, as I said, not every fight has to be piss easy. You gotta make an incentive to get some weapons, you know? Exactly, middle of the road, that's why it's C tier. Bubbleman, because why not? If you have epilepsy or anything like that, please look away now. This hurts. My eyes, they burn with fire. This is absolutely painful. And I'm so glad that in Mega Man Maker, we decided to totally redesign the Bubble Man waterfall background. Because this is abysmal. This is... Ugh. Just wait till you get some stages actually B-A tier. B tier for... This stage does not deserve a B tier. It's really jet betrayed. We have to at this stage. Okay, you are allowed to look again if you surfed from epilepsy, because now it's just a blue background. Bubble, bubble. So, water stages. You jump really high. And that is why water stages are usually pretty fun in Mega Man games. So, we start off with actually, like, instantly a mid-boss that just spawns enemies. And you gotta hit this little antenna down there. Like, it's a cool design, I guess, but it's a bit spammy, I would say. Good water effects, at least for the NES. It was a water purification plant. Oh, that's neat. I guess that fits. Water stages are great, Mega Man, because they're just space stages in this. Yeah. That's why Mega Man 1 has no water levels. And yeah, Metroids for no reason. I just got to hear. But yeah, this is a problem that we'll see a few other times as well. Over-reliance on spikes during water stages. And as we all know, spikes are instant kills, so if you get a bit too funny with your jumping, you're just dead. Yeah, the song is pretty nice. Water stages are pretty fun around here. Scroll started right reading a 10-foot for fishbowl. Oh, they're a variant of CWU? Oh, that's neat. Yo, look at all those, those drops. Okay, just another warning, if you have epilepsy, please look away again. Yeah, like, this is just bad. This is just bad. I don't tag play Mega Man. That would be funny. That would be funny. Okay, you can look again if you have epilepsy. I post Doki Doki Panics Waterfall in the server. It's a mess. Yeah. So, Bubble Man. This on the CRT would be hard. Oh, yeah. So, Bubble Man is kinda interesting. Like, when you're on the same altitude as him, he shoots these small shots that deal barely any damage. He flops all around, swims and stuff. And these bubbles he shoots are also... They aren't that hard to dodge, but they can catch you off guard if you don't know the pattern. Overall, I don't think Bubble Man is the worst fight ever. There's just a lot of... You gotta be aware of your positioning and stuff, and yeah. But yeah, overall, not that bad. The stage, though! The stage, though! Like, gameplay-wise, it wasn't even that offensive. Just kind of... Eh? Like, it just existed. But the background really, really needs to be changed. Oh boy. Stage select. Alright, alright, alright. Bubble Man. Sprite. Sometimes I hate Google Images, because it just never gives me a good, clean image of something. Oh well. Alright. Where to put this little fucker then? Everyone's saying D, C, D. It's not a C, because even though it was average as fuck, I don't think the background does it any favors. Like, consider you epileptic. That's an issue. My eyes are bleeding, World 3 Waterfall. Oh my god, what the fuck? Ugh. The thumbnail alone scares me. I guess, I feel like a D tier would be okay. Yeah. Below Flashman, though. So these Flashmen had some more ideas and stuff. But I don't think having limbs in every game would be okay, but you can't, that's an exaggeration. Like, epilepsy is a thing that actually is an issue for people playing video games. Okay, fair enough, but like, it's still not easy on the eyes, you know? My point stands, it hurts my eyes, fuck it. Alright, now we got these two fucking dickweeds left. Who we going? Like, I don't care, I could go with either one of them right now. Metal Man Pog? Metal Man Pog it is! 24th December. What? What kind of Disney shit is this? So if you decided to just grab a drink while you're waiting... Yeah, don't do that. At least the game gives you literally a free tank here. So I guess that's nice. You could totally cheese this section with Time Stopper. But we gotta be authentic here, you know? And get ready for Sprite Flicker! Oh yeah, that's a good Sprite Flicker, oh yeah! Oh yeah, that's a good one. One of the road riders from 7 was December 7. I feel like you mean Shademan or something. How do you think about your next boss? Also, PK FRE tank, oh yeah. Now this section just is annoying. Enemies spawn randomly out of the ground and ceiling, and yeah, it's just spammy as fuck. Really spammy as fuck. But hey, you could grind Lifeseer and stuff if you wanted. Why would you? Doesn't capture a nice finals win. Battle at Sony College and a shit botch white battle on us as fuck. Honestly though. There's a one up if you've got a utility. I guess it's pretty nice. But yeah, honestly, the conveyor belts, they don't add much. They're just kind of annoying and force you to jump a lot. That's kinda. I'm sure you need to figure that out. Horribly good is the sponge is never on you if you're standing still. Yeah, that's the thing. Like, especially in like super tiny hallways, it's just annoying. Meanwhile, these enemies, I mean, they're fine, but nothing ever happens with them. Scrap recycling plant. Makes sense. Makes sense. You can't tell Luigi anything. My man Lugi, the poor dude. Oh great, now I get to show what happens if you just hit him with a Buster Shot. Well, that wasn't the best example, but you know, it works. Alright. E-Tank over here, if you don't have item 2 any other means to get out, you're fucked. Trade your life for an E-Tank. Will you do it? I wouldn't. I'm noticing. Probably that's fucking brutal. What are you noticing? Wow, game design! So Metal Man's fired. No free tank. Metal Man's fired doesn't dink fully charged. Yeah, exactly. So Metal Man's fired is... Like, you really gotta misdirect the shots. Or you could do the funny left-right dance with him if you're really feeling funky today. But yeah, he jumps to 3 different altitudes, shooting 1, 2, or 3 metal blades depending on the height. And they're always aimed at your direct position when he fires, so you can easily misdirect them and... Yeah. It can get a bit hectic, especially with the conveyor belt. I don't think the conveyor belt adds too much to a fight, sadly, but... It is what it is. Most of his specials are probably from 2, because... Mega Man 2 best game. Custom moves were a cool idea. I missed them, honestly. Okay, Metal Man stage. No, don't select the whole chat. Okay, Metal Man Sprite. There he is. There he is. Pause, champ. Flip around, dude. Right, right, well, C is, like, very generous, I would say. Like as I said, the beginning section with the spiky things just drags, and the moles just make it drag even more. The conveyor belts add next to nothing. And, yeah. And I feel that they just forgot about the conveyor belts in the second half, kind of. Which is...
Not sure you should just forget about your main gimmick like that, shouldn't you?
Yeah. Like, the stage just has nothing going for it, is the thing. It is better than Crashman, though. I would... Is it better than Yeah, I think Crashman is the worst out of the E stages so far. Which one was Crashman? No, that's Wood, that's Flash, that's Crash, there you go. Move over. It is not easy to play some of these sometimes. But, whatever. I know exactly where I'm placing this guy though. I know exactly where he's going. So, Quickman stage! Starts off with just some weird hallways, nothing too fancy, sure, gotta ease them in. But then! Jesus beams! Now, I know people complain about this. I don't think that is the problem here. Anyways, here's a section that I believe should have been in Heatman stage, honestly. I feel like it would have fit there way better than here just randomly thrown in. So, yeah. It's very out of place. But yeah. Now it's time for the second half of the stage already, which, What do you want, Fire Maze Heatman stage? You're crazy! Jesus, beams are nice, but it becomes too crazy. Like, the thing is, once you know the pattern, you can beat it every time. It's not hard. It's just a bit of trial and error, and you can cheese it with Flash Stopper if you really want. I'd have no issues with this. It's a good idea for how you would do a quick-oriented stage. But the problem is how they decide to end the stage. One mech armor? Okay, I can deal with that. Then there's some bumpy bumps. And another mech armor that you really can't deal with. And you can see what I mean, you can see what I mean, yeah! Yeah. Yeah. I think you see the problem. Like, imagine you get through all those fucking quick lasers and then you have to deal with two or even more of those fucking mech armors. Why? Why? And to top it off, there's this fight, which, his AI is not made for this, arena. He breaks on this arena. He runs into walls all the time and it's just not... It's not made for him. Fight him on a flat surface and it's fine. But on this arena, it's absolute... It's just broken beyond belief and just makes it unnecessarily hard. And yeah, sometimes he just yeets at you somehow and it's very unpredictable. Like, there is some kind of rhyme and reason against it. But I don't think you should put the broken arena as the first fight against him. Meh. His first time usually is a boss worse than first test usually gets hit by the bosses. Why am I having many fox sounds in my head when you see what I mean? Thank you! I'm kill. So. Quick man, eh? Quick man, eh? S plus. You can pick the stage first. Exactly. That's another thing. So, I said I knew where I put him already. Yeah. No big surprise there, I would say. It looks like a Christmas tree. But. Yeah, I got the lords out there. Yeah, let's go. This game is smarter than Red Robot Master. That's true. But yeah. Are you ready for just it getting way worse? Cause I'm not. All but two weapons are awful, everything else mediocre best. They are the ding of a lot of damage, don't do enough damage, don't do enough inner DVD or the bubble letter take shots to call a shot. But I'm not ready. Ear strain. Overrated song. I'm ready for my headache or eyebrows. G tier, please. Z tier. Yes, we all know this song is overused. It's a song. I can see why people would like it, but Jesus Christ, there's other songs in the world. Calm down. One game theme. Yeah, let's go. So starting off in Wily 1. We just spam some shit and then, hey, a wall! Good thing you've got these utility weapons. Yeah, I guess that works. Like, yeah, it's not bad, but it's been ruined. But yeah. Over-reliance on utilities already. Already. So it's obvious that it once may have been. Yeah, but still. It has been already. Oh, I would play I Wanna Be The Guy someday. That would be fun. That would be really fun. Why he wanted weakest zero? Where the fuck are these enemies? Which enemies? The ones that just... the squams? Oh, one second in particular. Ah, yes. So here you can actually sit on the ladder and just kind of cheese out these enemies. Kinda weird. Not sure if that's intended or anything. Shredding pippies with a metal blade is a dopamine factory! Yeah! Squirms are called toothpaste machine. I think that's squirms, actually. Yeah, it's a bit finicky to get the positioning right here, but yeah, it works. Alright. So, now we move up again. Jump over you. Get ready to equip item 1. And here's this place. Now, if you keep dying to the boss, you gotta do this section over and over, I'm pretty sure. And you gotta grind. You gotta grind weapon energy for item 1, most likely on some Sniper Joes. Ain't that fun. But for now, we just do the funny jumpies. If you're good, I think you can just do it with 2 of them, but I feel like 3 is a good save. The 1 is mirrored. Good. Good. Okay, and that's the stage already, which, you know, great. Ready for the boss, who is just a flicker fest? A massive flicker fest with bottomless pits over it. If you've watched my Rosenkreuzstele at the Let's Play recently, you might recognize the One of Doom as the Mecha Dragon. Yeah, seizure warning, absolutely. Absolutely. Yes, especially when the game lags, your knockback gets increased tenfold for some reason. And that's just not good. That's just horrible. That is just brr. Did the World of Doom stop? I mean, so did the Mecha Dragon. It stopped in the exact same block layout. I've heard a million times, but nobody's game is bad. Haven't heard that one before. Right, get that. Didn't see the cause of writing. Man, imagine writing. Well, imagine seeing, actually. I can't see. Mega 2 doesn't have checkpoint before the boss in one stage, at least my mom put you right before the... That's the thing. That's the thing. Mommy, I don't like the stage, make it go away. Yeah. The thing is, a lot of people use Quick Boomerang as its weakness. It still only deals 1 damage. Yeah. So, there's no point. Save your Quick Boomerangs for later. Alright, let's try this again. Thing is also, if you keep hitting him while he's spewing fire, he just won't stop spewing fire! And my eyes, they burn with fire! Yeah! Yeah! Sure is. Dude! I told you, epilepsy warning!
The reason why this tutorial going on waiting for the time when we slow down the life of playing is not based on a...
Can't go ahead and quick, no! Okay, okay. Mecha Dragon Sprite. Yes, Sprite. There's a lot of ammo and it even kills big fish. I guess, but meh. Right, I think it's pretty safe to say F tier. F tier stage, no respect. You missed a horrible stage, and it's time for another horrible stage. Are you ready? Wily 2! Wily 2. At the very least, they start off with web energy to get you back on your feet a bit. Because they knew. They just knew. Don't mind me. Alright. Flashing aside, I'd put it higher at least if it's in clever screen, but I like this from the stage. Alright, moving on! Forced web usage of item 2 now. Like, I guess it looks cool for the first time, but And once again, at the very least. No, I don't have to make more tiers, I think I've got a good coverage here. So yeah. At least they refill your item too. Now this is a trap. Just like that one annoying meme back in the day.
Waiting, but it isn't as bad as the other candidates.
Fun fact, you've jumped over the crush was with the... Yeah, that's true, but I wouldn't have gotten the funny weapon energy then. Put everything in shit here. So, you could bomb these walls. But, why would you? Why would you? It's just a waste of web energy, honestly. Speaking of wasting web energy, let's use Leaf Shield here because I can't be asked. Because fuck this hallway. It's padding at its finest. Gotta do the obligatory, don't you mind me. One up drops are now at 4. wasting weapon energy, you said, gets weapon energy, yeah. The drop rates in this game are weird, as I said. Here's some required item 3 usage. Now this seems like it forces, it wants you to use Time Stopper, but... You can do it fine without. Also, why is there just VHS spindles down here? I don't get it. Makes boss economic with expensive weapon. Haha, I have crush boss for backups. It's arguably better for the moles. That could be true. I'm using data mine and mega. So, if you've watched my Rosenkotschdilette let's play, you might recognize this boss as the glass window. Literally the same thing. Does a shit ton of damage.
gets increasingly faster. Dies in one hit to a funky weapon. Yeah. Just kinda is.
Also, once again, epilepsy warning for when I kill the boss. Be careful. Yeah. Yeah. This is the yes, Tech. You fired the whole glass window. Blocks on the ground are kind of bullshit. Exactly. I swear it's Dark Souls 2. I have to actually cover my eyes. The epilepsy is so bad. Everyone's complaining about it. It pleases me that people don't like it. It pleases me. Right.
MM2 Wily 2 boss.
I don't know what you call that boss, man.
I don't know what the name of that.
Anyways, new layer, there he is. Let's just make it bigger for a second so I can erase him. Could have been done better. Oh well. I would say better than Mecha Drang stage. Not by a long shot. Just barely better. Just barely better. Just barely. Isn't that... That's a staircase! Yeah, we made a staircase! Let's go! Let's go! Okay. So, Wily 3... Can you even call Wily 3 a stage? It's barely a stage, I would say. Whatever, let's refill ourselves a bit. Okay. This enemy is, like, super useless. I feel bad for him. That's why I shot him. I will rate the revisit stage. Oh, wait, there's the boss with the pretty much the other world. Overall, I don't know how to feel about the boss refights yet. Was it 4? Or was it 5? Like, I died once on the... Oh, was it 4? Okay. Alright. Oh yeah, here's Big Fish. Just, I feel like it's meant to be a jump scare or something, but I don't know, man. Motherfucker falling like a rock. I mean, he's a robot, so. That jump scare, yeah. Back in the day, and those were the jump scares. Also, Spike fall, because why not? Why not? In a fucking science girl, that jump scare. He's got rock, man, in Japan. Yeah, let's go. Yeah, that's a bit tight, if you wanna dodge that, actually. It's a bit of a blind shot there. Whatever. And that's the stage already. That's the stage already. Now this boss... Once again, epilepsy warning! Was kinda quick. G tier! G tier! The G's! The G's! God stows a moment. Everyone's saying G tier! What the hell? Okay, God stows a sprite. There he is. K tier. My god! You guys are harder than me. Actually, you guys are just going lower and lower now. But, like, the stage, there was nothing in it. It was inoffensive as fuck, but the boss was epileptic. At least the boss wasn't bullshit. Like, I gotta say E, actually. I know it sounds weird, but... It sounds weird. Yeah, let's just... Shuffle these guys around real quick. Where's Metal Man? Yeah, you gotta. That's wrong. Yeah, you gotta shuffle one more. Twitter cancel thread. See, the thing is, it doesn't have any forced weapon usage. It doesn't have many bullshit moments, if any. The boss is just kinda there. It's nowhere near as bad as Heatman, Quickman, the Boobeam, the Pico Pico Kun or Mecha Dragon. The Shotmen are bullshit, yes, that's why it's still an E tier, but it is not as bad as Airman, Metalman or Crashman, I would say. It's barely a stage, that's exactly it, that's why it can't get any higher. It's highly underwhelming for like one of the final stages, sure, but I don't think it's too bad. Alright, now that I got that out of the way. I swear I could use it as a tutorial. I'll slip you 20. Okay, if someone gifts me some subs to the Twitch chat right now, I will put it in F tier. That would be such a weird thing. Tech said tutorial. He did say tutorial. He did. He did. Yeah, that meta is like frame perfect dodging bullshit for no reason. I don't know, man. Oh well. This stage is abysmal. No, thank you. I do not want to become famous, but thank you for the offer. Thank you. Goodbye. Shut up, Tech. This is really fun, I hate the boss. See, the stage isn't even fun. Like, sure, we've got this idea. And, like, I feel like they want you to use Bubble Net for that. But, thing is, you need Bubble Net later. So, if you, like, try to over-rely on them now, you're gonna bite yourself in the ass so hard. Yeah, Tech, the if is more important. Hey, host! The fuck decided the iron card doesn't invalidate LNBs? Man, I don't know. Click on the pumpkin to make him bigger. Buy money! Okay, so now we got the Crashman section, but just worse. Worse in every way. Worse in every fucking way. Once again, just a lot of stupid waiting where nothing's really happening. Maybe you shoot an enemy or two. But yeah, nothing happens. Nothing happens. Just buy a bit of bigger blanket. Almost nothing! Isn't buying money just how cryptocurrency works? Technically, I would say. Metal blade for that. Just complete the stage, forehead. Yeah, exactly. See, that's actually another problem I have with this game. There's like no real place to use any of your weapons, really. Like, most of the time it's just, yeah, you just gotta get through this. But there's no where you could really use your weapons in a clever way. And that's sad. Like, this is like the only way where place I would use air shooter, really. And even then, you ready for this? Yeah. If you don't have an atomic fire charged up fully as you enter that hallway, you're getting hit. You're getting hit. And I do not feel like wasting my atomic fire right now. Yeah, undodgeable sniper Joe. Fucking hyper, just go away. Just go away, okay. Now is they picking up the weapon, two spells made two. I mean, that's just the sprite limits, I guess. You can't really blame the game for that. But yeah. Now, you need a specific weapon to kill this boss. If you die to this boss, and don't have enough weapon energy anymore, you gotta grind weapon energy on the mech armors and the sniper Joes. Yeah. 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 May I welcome you to, once again warning for epilepsy, may I welcome you to Boobeam Trap. Maybe this works? Yeah! There we go. See, you can cheese it a bit. You can cheese it a bit. Where are you? Hello. Yeah, I don't think that's gonna hit the top one. Nah, whatever. That's a shame. That's a shame. Demonic laughter. Yep, exactly. Exactly that. We can't even see the sprite. Oh, that's a shame. So yeah, that is probably one of the worst stages in all of Mega Man history. Like, yikes. Like, it was literally nothing. I gotta watch the stream out after that. That must have looked funny as fuck. That must have looked so bad. Oh boy.
Boobeam Trap Sprite. That's not a sprite, but sure, I'll use this because I don't care. Can't think of a worse stage. I mean...
Like, I can't even be asked to put a proper thing here, but yeah, just gonna put him, like, right in the corner there. Go sit in the corner! You did the best! You're in timeout now! You're in timeout! What were they thinking?
The timeout corner.
So, now it's time for King 2. Oh, King 2. Oh, why did you have to remind me of King 2? Yeah, let's go back to Brazil. So, boss refights. I guess this is where we see how well the weakness works against each boss. Or something. Oh, that's where I would do, but we can't really utilize some of the weaknesses. Crash Bomb in particular. Yeah, once again, Airman showing off his incredible skills of just random bullshit. Always a pleasure. Always a pleasure. At least... you get health if you kill a boss. And you don't have to do them all in one run. You can die, and it saves who you killed. So yes. It's not that bad. Once again, check. I guess there's another thing I could talk about real quick. The weapon balancing in this game is absolutely abysmal as well. We all know Metal Blade is like the best weapon ever, yada yada yada. Sure, but it also leaves the problem of... all the other weapons just turn into useless garbage. There's no reason to use any of them, really, other than boss weaknesses. Like, Metal Blade is just the answer to everything, kind of, which just... Like, I like it if every weapon has some kind of purpose, you know? Like, sure, you can't make every weapon the best weapon ever, but... just make them unique, make them, like, fun and stuff. Like, Air Shooter is unique and stuff, but there's no reason to use it ever. Enemies above you, just Metal Blade them. Those ignorant lists. Oh yeah, also funny Metal Blade fact. Yeah. My message is better visible. Oh yeah, little glitch here, if I can pull it off. Yeah, there we go. Neat little glitch, I guess. So the boss refights, fine, I can live with that. It shows growth, kind of, how far you've come and stuff. I can live with that. I'm not gonna rag on that every game from now on, because it's a formula that works now. Sure. What doesn't work is this next boss. Phase 1, Sure, it's just these swingy bullets. That's fine. That's fine, I can live with that. Phase 2, on the other hand, is impossible. And I don't mean it in a haha funny way. I mean it in a... You literally cannot dodge these balls. I've tried with Taz before. The hitboxes are just too dang big and don't even fit on the balls sometimes. It just doesn't... It's not feasibly possible to do it no damage. You're pretty much forced to use knee tank there, sometimes. So that's You can in test, but guess he was alive. The thing is, maybe if you get lucky, you can do it in test. Maybe. But it's not consistent. Sometimes you just get walled and there's no real way out. Boss fight? The boss rush I can live with, once again. I can live with a boss rush. That's fine. That's fine. Dr. Wily Sprite, can I just get a Wily Sprite, please? Thank you. Actually, no, I should get the Wily Machine. MM2 Wily Machine Sprite. There we go. There we go. There it is. There it is. No, Tech, there's still one more stage. So, how do we rank the boss rush stage then? See, the thing is, boss rush, it's fine. But the boss fight after at the Wily Machine. Yeah, I feel like that would be an F. Yeah. Put it just slightly above the other two. Which one was it? There it is. Scoot over, you two cunts. No, not you. You can stay. Except you. You can stay. The ladder continues. Alright. Yeah, the phone is just sometimes doing stuff. Anyways, Yeah, I should select that. Okay. The stage is... It exists. Sure. Ambience. Very much ambience. That's the stage. Like, it's just a hallway to get you hit a few times. Now, this next boss, the final boss, if you hit it with any weapon that isn't bubble led, it gets a full heal. Just keep that in mind for what's about to happen. Alien Wily has a very simple pattern. He flies around in an infinity pattern, and occasionally shoots a pellet at you. If you run into him, you take abysmally high amounts of damage. And if you run out of bubble head for whatever reason, you got a game over. So you can have more weapon energy, because there's no way you can recover any weapon energy anymore. Nope, Mega Buster also heals it. Yeah, I'll demonstrate. I'll use the rewind to show it again. There you go. You see what happened? Exactly. Worst. Shitfight. Absolute shitfight. And yet, most you can take. Ah! I should have said epilepsy warning, I'm sorry! Oh god, that's not the I forgot about it! Oh, that's horrible! Oh god! Oh, I'm so sorry! I forgot about that! Ah! let alone makes a difference. Can't ignore that. Look at Wily's legs. Alright, Wily alien sprite. Now we're getting any sprites here, what the fuck? Man, I'm just getting images, what the fuck? Whatever. Gonna... Like, it's even worse because you're literally at the end of the game and then you just get fucking yeeted by a stupid shit. Yeah. Like, the fact that this is at the end of the game, that's not excusable. You sprite sink. I would, but I can't be asked right now. And then fucking dies for having a seizure. Okay, we get back to the tier list in a second, but let's just watch the credits for now. Mega Man 2, what a game. What an abysmal, abysmal game. All the enemies in Woodman's stage die in one hit to leave shield, but you... Ah, ain't that fun. Like, there's no reason to code that in then. Like, there's no reason. There's just no reason for that at all. Okay, final thoughts, I guess. As you can see, the game's super overrated, still is. The fact that people just blindly praise this game means no answer will take the series seriously and give the easy fix that I couldn't know if this demand then I had to see the rest, just horrible. The only game series which auto steals the spotlight on your. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. Pretty much what Ace said. Like, everyone always praises this game because of their stupid shit nostalgia goggles. Because, oh, this was my first NES game, wah, wah, wah. Mm. The thing is, just, we had no stage above C, and the only C stage was Woodman. All of the Wily Castle except Gutsdozer was F rank. The late game is so badly laid out. There's no consideration for dying here. Like, you either do it perfectly, or you just get fucked by everything. And you have to grind for so much. The Robot Master stages, sure, I can accept that some of them poop, but there's just so many problems, and keep in mind, some of these are problems that Mega Man 1 had, and I hoped they would be fixed. Like, over-reliance on weapons in the fortress stages or something, and stuff like that. Yeah, that's not good. Low E tier mathematically. If we look at it in a purely mathematic sense, sure, but... Are we? Mega Man 2 title screen... The thing is, are we looking at it in a mathematical sense today? Or are we looking at it in a this is a video game sense? Low E would make sense, but it feels... I feel like I'm super obliged to just throw it in F tier, because there is no way in hell this is worthy of an E tier at this point. I do not think this is in any way redeemable. In some ways. Like, sure, you could fix it up. I'm sure you could make it a good game. There are some interesting ideas here. But how they pulled it all off in general. It's so player unfriendly. It just doesn't... just no. Mega Man 2... That is true. Mega Man 2 Atari is a very good in... interpretation of Mega Man 2. Roadmasters can be average when you have no idea, but the late game is too much. Mm-hmm. Exactly. The late game is really the cataclysm that destroys this whole game, in a sense. And sadly, that's Mega Man 2. The best game, as said by many people. And a lot of people say, well, if this is the best game, then it's so shit, well, it can only get worse from here. Nah, I think we're on a upward slope now. We've seen some of the worst. Let's climb upwards. Tech, even still, I'm not the biggest fan of the soundtrack, honestly. So, like, it's not bad, but It's... Can't wait for seeing the stream dislikes. Yeah, that's gonna be great! That's gonna be so great! Oh.
Mega Man Boomers be like, 2 is the best and Metal Maze are the best in the entire series.
I know tech, but I'm saying I just don't like some of the songs in general. Like Airman's theme, I don't like it at all.
I don't like it.
Anyways, that leaves us with... What's next? Well, we could go to Mega Man 3, but I think it's time for a little break. When next time on this series, we're heading to Mega Man World 1 for the Nintendo Game Boy. I'm excited for that game because I hope that some stuff will definitely be improved upon from the NES games. For now, presented by Capcom, they did a shit job. Thanks for watching Mega Man 2.